want to remind you that God loves us so much. And every day of our lives, God keep giving us opportunity and reason to trust in Him. Reason to believe in Him and reason to become better people. I mean, every day that breaks is an opportunity. Every day that breaks is an opportunity. Opportunity for you to do the right thing. Opportunity for you to live the right life. Opportunity for you to amend your wrongs. Because one day will become the day of the Lord. And that brings us to the topic for today, the great day of the Lord. The great day of the Lord. God has given every other days of your life to you. But one day will be His day. And we seem to enjoy the days of our lives. We seem to enjoy the opportunity we have, the advantages we have. And we forget about the most important day, which is the great day of the Lord. I mean, when you are aware of the great day of the Lord, you will live your life in fear and trembling towards salvation and eternal life. Because if everything will expire, if everything will end, then on our scale of preference, we should make sure that we have the most important thing on the top list. There are things that are far important than the rest. Others may be important, but not as important as some. Everything is sweet and okay now, that we tend not to see signs of what the Bible is talking about yet. I mean, deep signs. And we think it may not be. I don't think it will be like that. But I tell you, every day you have is an opportunity for you to amend your ways and do the right thing. Because God has given you all your days, and one day will be His. If you don't take advantage of the days you have, I mean, seize the opportunity of the days you have to right your wrong, one day, the devil will prove your faith in God wrong. If you don't take advantage of the days you have, I mean, seize opportunity to right your wrong, one day, the devil will prove your faith in God wrong. And it will be so bad that you are proven wrong. And indeed, it is wrong. Let's not forget that no matter how great, mighty, powerful, influential, famous, popular we are, all that starts here and ends here. The Lord sent a message to Zephaniah. The book of Zephaniah, chapter 1, verse 14. The great day of the Lord is near. Near and hastening fast, the mighty man cries aloud there. A day of wrath is that day, a day of distress and anguish, a day of rain and devastation, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of trumpet blast and battle cry against the fortified cities and against the lofty battlements. I will bring distress on men so that they shall walk like the blind because they have sinned against the Lord. Their blood shall be poured out like dust and their flesh like dung. Verse 18, very important. Neither their silver nor their gold shall be able to deliver them. On the day of the wrath of the Lord, in the fire of His jealousy wrath, all the earth shall be consumed. For a fool, yes, sudden end, he will make of all the inhabitants of the earth. Then, chapter 2, Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1. Come together and hold assembly, O shameless nation, before you are driven away like the drifting chaff. Before there comes upon you the fierce anger of the Lord. Before there comes upon you the day of the wrath of the Lord. Seek the Lord, all you humble of the land, who do this command, seek righteousness, seek humility. Perhaps you may be hidden on the day of the wrath of the Lord. Your silver, your gold will not save you that day. Is it good for us to have money? Be wealthy, be rich, it's very good. You need it in this life. But you shouldn't top your preference lists. I mean, your preferential list shall have the most important thing. We have things that are important. We have things that are most important. Look at great men today. Death is sure and is a fact of life. That either you believe it exists or not, it will still come to you. We have sure facts of life, death and sickness. Either you believe they exist or not, they will still come to you. And they come to you unannounced. So when you prepare for such day, that a healthy body may become very sick. A living body may be dead. And once that comes, there may be no opportunity to make the wrong right, to ask for mercy, and to ask for grace. One day, another day will start without you. One day, even people that hated you will say, I wish he didn't die. One day, people will come from far and near to give you the last respect. One day, the same way you attend people's burial, the surest thing is that they will attend yours too. One day, you also be in the casket and they do line instead for you. One day, people will cry and wish you never left. You can hear, you may hear, but nothing you can do about it. One day, your picture will be everywhere, trending. This one, this man, this woman is gone. One day, you will stay somewhere where you have no family anymore. It will just be you and you. You will stay where you can't see your father, your mother, your sibling, your children, your spouses anymore. One day. The more we prepare for that day, the more our future is assured. The more we prepare for that day, the more our future is assured. Because if your future is not eternal, you're already walking down to the grave. Your future should be what? Eternal. One day, you fight. You become fleshly. You become powerful. Everybody, I will lock you up. One day, you lose all that strength, all that power, all that influence. One day. So in all we look for from God, let's ask him for mercy that on that great day, we will not be found wanting. I know life is very stressful. It's everywhere. I know we are going through a lot. It's everywhere. I know we are looking for a solution to our problem. People are having solution too, at different levels too. You have problem. I have problem. I can still come here and tell you, be encouraged, my brother, with my own problem as a pastor. Because that's what I'm trying to do. Say, don't cry. But I just finished crying in the house before I come out to church. But I'm going to tell you, why are you crying? Don't cry. So when you feel you have problem, don't also forget that people also what? And this problem is not excluded to anybody. One thing I know, never a problem Never a problem Jesus cannot solve. Never a problem Jesus cannot solve. Most times your existence is tied to that problem. Like it told Paul, my grace is sufficient. Go ahead, don't worry. Just go through it. Every day I sleep and wake up, I know that it's an opportunity to keep moving. Don't let anything make you deviate from the power of God. Most of us have made mistakes because of problems, as I said. So the things you think you are going through may be what will give birth to the main miracle you are looking for. Because until that situation attracts help, you will never get one. So God will allow it to make you look reproaching. It becomes a mockery just to attract help. Are you getting the point? So you, what kind of mockery is this? What kind of reproach is this? But God knows that until you get to that level, nobody will answer you. That reproach may be for just 1 month. Maybe for 1 year. Maybe for 2 years. The mockery may just be for a season. All what you want is the right person to come your way. The day that person comes, the mockery stops.
Yes, sir.
Now, let me tell you something about it. You see, when the Lord finally comes to your aid and gives you blessings and answers your prayer, even those that mock you, when they see you on another level, they will keep quiet. Because they will look at you and they see that your level has changed. They can't insult you anymore. You get my point? So forget about the mockery and the reproach. Make sure that you get to where God wants you to be. Because they can still be looking at you. But they can't say anything anymore. God is so precise. He's very intentional about everything he does. Most of the time, our senses will contradict those things. Why? But these are the very things, the essentials we need. I run off by saying that the very essentials of life are found among the common. The very essential things of life are found among the common. You don't buy air, you breathe. You don't, salt is cheap. Water is everywhere. Let your body lose any of those things. Are you hearing me? Can you stay without salt? You know the result. Water. Then air. But you find it everywhere. It's so common. By the time you lie down on the bed and they say that you need to buy the air, then you understand better. So most times, God wants you to appreciate what he wants, what he's doing for you. He said, no problem. You think I've not blessed you, right? I'm not doing anything for you. No problem. Come and use your money and buy the blessing you want. By the time you stay there for 1 week, you understand that you'll be bankrupt. You'll be broke. And God has kept you for 30 years. And you think he's keeping you for 30 years to rubbish you? No, he's not keeping you for 30 years to rubbish you. He has a plan. The plan may include mockery. The plan may include reproach. The plan may include shame. The plan may include delay. The plan may include disappointment. The plan may include confusion. It is a plan. It is what? It is a plan. Hold on. Let's finish the plan. Because that may just be a setup for your step up. It's a setup. Most times the devil will leave you because he thinks you are useless already. When he sees things befalling you, he says, okay, we are done now. Leave him. But that's God's setup for them to leave you. But deep inside of you, you are strong. Deep inside of you, you know what you are. You know that God is with you. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
So in all you do, don't let any day of your life pass by without amending your wrongs and doing the right thing. Hold on to God so strong and mighty. As long as you hold on to God, you trust in him, depend on him. Those who laughed at you will laugh with you. Those who laughed at you will laugh with you. Because you get to a point, somebody will come and tell you,
I used to think it is this way. I used to think you would not be helpful. I'm sorry, my brother. I'm sorry, my sister. I was only thinking that is the work of the Lord. Chill. Calm down. It's only God that can promise you a thing and fulfill it. It's only God. I can promise you something as a man. I will not be able to do it on time. Yes. I will not even be able to do it at all. But you see, God, no matter how long it takes, no matter how long it stays, if he has said it, he will do it. Because he that promised is faithful. Leave it for him. Don't time God. Because when you start timing God, you'll be desperate. You have an obsession. Don't time God. Every day you sleep and wake up is a new day. And a new opportunity. Don't say, Father, next month, this month. You may have faith, but don't time him. Oh, do you know that you can spend 40 years in shame, in mockery, in pain. Then all of a sudden your story changes. That God will say, this man spent almost half of his years in shame. For this reason, let me give him wealth. And also give him health. And give him long life. To enjoy all the days the cankerworm have eaten and the caterpillar have destroyed. That's God for you. Because you can be wealthy, but you're not healthy. The preacher says, thank God for giving you wealth and health to enjoy the world. These are two different blessings. You can have so much money, but you must not miss your appointment with the doctor. Four times, three times, two times. If they ask you to pay once and for all to be healthy, you can pay even 10 times. But you see, life is not fair. You have to go through what you have to go through.
Yes, sir.
That's why you have to make your right wrong right. So that when you're supposed to retire, you will not get tired. When you're supposed to retire, you'll not do what?
Get tired.
Because one day you will retire. Let it be that when you retire, you have peace. I round it up by opening the book of Revelation chapter 2 from verse 4 to 7. Revelation chapter 2 from verse 4 to 7. But I have this against you, that you have abandoned the love you had at first. Remember then from what you have fallen. Repent and do the works you did at first. If not, I will come to you and remove your lampstand from its place. Unless you repent. Yet, this you have. You hate the works of the Nicolaitans, which I also hate. He who has ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To him who conquers, I will grant to eat of the tree of life, which is in the paradise of God. The only way we can access God's mercy is by what? Repentance. You don't cry. It's not by crying. It's not by shedding tears. The genuineness of your heart attracts God's mercy to you. As you continue to sojourn, as you continue to walk, as you continue to be on this course, don't forget that you rise, you will fall. Things will happen. Tests will come. Trials will come. But make sure that you don't remain there when you fall. To fall is normal. But to remain there will become your responsibility. It is normal that you fall because you are fighting. Most times you enter way is stronger than you do, bring you down. But stand up and do what? And keep fighting. Hold on to your faith and hold on to your confession. No pastor, no prophet, nobody can help you except who?
God.
Except God. Please, there's nothing God cannot do. Be patient with God. I believe that one day, all of us will come to a place of total freedom. Amen. Where we give God praise. Amen. Please sit down. Don't be desperate. Tell your neighbor, don't be desperate. Don't be obsessed. Don't be desperate. Don't give God time. Let the will of God be done. For his will is perfect. May God bless his word. In Jesus' name.